Hello, dear centers, and welcome back for another exciting day of Oxygen Not Included. We're starting off on a high note with new research technologies at our fingertips. This time, it's interior decor technology, which includes such amazing new inventions as the ceiling lamp, which we can now replace floor lamps with, mess tables so that our colonists can eat at a table to reduce stress instead of eating on the floor, sculpting blocks and blank canvases so our artists have work to do. Specifically, I'm only going to have one artist. In this case, Pam has a creativity level of 8, which far exceeds anyone else's creativity level. And I want to try the decor out right now by getting a couple of sculpting blocks going in on either side of our little home base area. Well, maybe I can put them on the outside just so that we don't get in the way of the outhouse, which still needs to move at some point down the road. Also, check out this new interesting discovery. The levels of water are going down. As soon as I loaded back into the game, I saw water down here collecting in our new pool. So apparently just resetting the game, reloading the save, revealed the invisible water. So there was water down here. People were actively gathering it from this location. We just couldn't physically see it grow until now. So I'm curious if that's going to continue to be the case, if it's actually draining more than it looks, or if we just need to be patient and wait and see. For now, we'll be patient, and if I need to reload a save here in a little while, maybe I will. But for now, we're doing pretty good as far as resource generation and our reports go. Take a look at yesterday. We're producing over 100 kilograms of oxygen more than we are removing. So all of our mini algae terrariums doing good work, and we still have 4,800 kilograms remaining, plus the algae that we can find here. But algae is not, hang on. Why do I have two people doing art? This is art, right? No, okay, here's the deal. They have to put the raw resources down and then the artist will come and sculpt from those resources. That makes sense. Also, how did all this sand stack up right here? Oh, we're digging straight up to get access to another pool of water to try to increase the size of the one that we've already got down here. So let's get a brand new water pump, liquid pump rather, centralized in this new pond, and we're going to have to connect up liquid pipe again. And that's going to be kind of difficult because it has to go all the way back up here and through the new little tunnel that we are digging. And I'm not sure, this might be too much water pressure for one single pipe. I'm unsure how this is going to work, but I'm going to give it a try. And hook it on up. Okay, let's see if it's too much. If it is, well, we'll have to come up with an alternate solution, probably. But for now, I think it'll do just fine. Okay, we are running low on meal lights. We have 10,000 kilocals of food, and that's not going to last us too long. So let's take a look around the environment and see. Atmospheric pressure is too low up here for these mealwood to grow. Only 45 g of breathable oxygen. It's all concentrated down here because we have no way for every bit of our little oxygen pressure down here to filter up through this single ladder. Yeah, I can see how that would be a problem. So how about we start digging out all of this dirt and create some ventilation shafts to allow that oxygen to go way further up. We got so many jobs queued up for our duplicants right now, they don't know what to do first. Pam is actively sculpting this new block. She's already finished this one over here. Mediocre sculpture. It's quaint. Okay, but it's a 20 decor with a radius of 8 blocks all the way around it. So that should help to start reducing stress, which we're kind of nipping in the bud, as it were, because our vitals here say highest stress is Bay, who has 5. Oh, no, Ada has 9%. Let's find out why. Dirty hands and grimy. Well, now that we've got a little bit of plumbing, water is flowing, right? Stands to reason that if we start making a lavatory, which should be under, I thought it would be under plumbing. Yeah, lavatory and shower will prevent disease and reduce stress while also improving hygiene. They would love to have one of each of these. That will absolutely be our focus today. Soon, my dear Ada, you will no longer have to plunge the outdated outhouses when their red arrows, like some carnival game, strikes the danger zone. I'm gonna upgrade you. In the plumbing tab, we can find the lavatory and the shower, as I said, but the shower is 4 blocks tall. So this is going to take a little bit of renovation, and I'm gonna do overkill, because that's what I do. Two showers and two lavatories. This is how it's ultimately going to look. We are going to start with just two of them for simplicity's sake, though, of course. And let's build some tile underneath, no longer out of igneous rock. Perhaps out of granite, though, but these are 200 apiece. I think granite is acceptable. So let's build the flooring here, and go ahead and tell everyone to dig all of this new area out. This will not infringe upon any of the other buildings that we have, but eventually this is going to be the new floor. The tile's going to go all the way over, the outhouse is going to be removed, so on and so forth. But you'll notice that each one of these two buildings need to have additional liquid pipes going to and fro, an intake and an outtake. This is where I am not quite sure what we need to do, because both of these buildings are going to produce some kind of waste, are they not? Let's take a look. Requirements: water, intakes and outputs. Makes sense. And it will have contaminated water shooting out of it. So we need a way to clean the water. Let's take a look here and see if such a filtration system can possibly be researched. This is exactly what I think. No, that selects one type of liquid, sending it into a separate pipe. This is an air scrubber, which sounds cool. Maybe it's under percolation. Water purifier. Boom. Found our next research. Percolation is going to be important for more than one reason anyway, as we will soon find out. Welcome to a new day, peons. Let's go 2x speed because I have so many jobs still left for you all to do, including completing the pipe and liquid pump, which of course is itself going to need electricity, right? Getting a little carried away there. And with that, we're going to have another source of water pouring into our currently empty pond. I'm sure that it's just some kind of bug with the liquid pumps, and that reloading the game will make this look like there's a lot more water there. I will try that out later after we get this new pump working for some time. Sound good? Anyway, back to where we were just a moment ago. Trying to figure out how we can have an input and an output and have them not mingle with each other. We do have a liquid pipe bridge, which I'm currently unsure how to use. For now, I'm going to split off the pipe here, which apparently has broken everything while I was holding that button down. And additionally, it's going to go up over here. So an easy way without having to use a liquid pipe bridge. Oops, that is not the O button. That is the O button. See, there is a way to try and flip these pipes around. Theoretically, this could go over the top of another pipe, like so. But you have to have empty space because it is quite a large contraption. The easier way would be to just have the output go up the wall instead of down the floor. So that way it'll be completely separated. And I'm okay with that. Now, the question is, where do we want to dump that nasty stink water? And that I do not know. We need to research the purifier and find a new location for our new toys. Let's begin helping the air dispersal problem that we currently are suffering from. Not enough thick air at the top? That says to me, how about we increase the width of this tube, the ladder chute, whatever you want to call it, with gas permeable tiles. That makes a lot of sense, right? If we're going to be using this anyway, let's not build it there because that's not the level that it's going to go on anyway. We can go here, here, and all the way across to the side without worrying about affecting the flow of oxygen or carbon dioxide across the base. That should already go a long way towards helping the air get to where it needs to go. I'm noticing it's getting trapped in this room as well, and we do have two permeable tiles that we could just keep building all the way up. The problem is getting that air over to the left quadrant of the base. There's still breathable air, but only barely. If we could just drain all this water, that would kind of solve my problem, because then these algae terrariums could shoot their oxygen straight up and we could just dig all this dirt out. And it would be wonderful. This lamp, no power, just get destroyed. Hey, finally, it's time to harvest some more lice. We only have 2,000 cake cows. There is a food shortage at hand. People are getting upset. People are getting hungry. I hope that they don't just eat the meal lice. That would be very bad. Good boy, Elvis. Don't put it in the ration box. Somebody else needs to go take it up to the mushers. We've got material. No, Pam. You dastardly, evil people. Well, this is how we're going to starve to death, in case you were curious. The duplicants have been running around like chickens with their heads cut off. building permeable tiles everywhere because I am sick and tired of having oxygen unable to flow throughout the base. So we got permeable tile above our printing pod leading all the way up to the tippy top and in our bedrooms, which are currently barely breathable. I aim to fix this. You can see how the water has glitched out here due to the pump. That water probably doesn't even exist anymore, by the way. It's about time to reload, but I'm just gotta keep seeing what's gonna happen next because we're almost out of food. We're getting a couple more harvests every so often, and I'm thinking that we just don't take a new duplicate. We can't afford to feed them. What happens if you reject all of them? It won't hurt their feelings. You can't use the printing pod again. What if I just leave it here? Then I have to listen to that noise. You know what? 8? That's enough duplicates for now. Go away. I'm sorry. I had to do it. We can't feed any more mouths right now. But we are actively harvesting some more meal lice, which we're gonna turn into some delicious food. I think 3 loaves apiece. And of course, we've got the 5 simultaneously now growing planter boxes. How are we doing up top? The millwood up here is mostly growing. Atmospheric pressure is still too low in places, but it is improving. It was at like 40 or 50. Now it's rising. 176, 77, 78. I think what we're doing is working. And let's look at the report for yesterday as well. Still about 100 kilograms of air added total. That's awesome. Now what I'm gonna do is finally reload and let's see how the water actually looks. And then of course we've got a new liquid pump about to be completed. Night night. And this is what our pump actually looks like. Still a bit of standing water here where the pump cannot reach. So it is time to do a little deconstruction. And check out what our self-made pool looks like. Much improved, don't you agree? So there's a little bit of a bug with water and keeping up with the supply while a pump is inside, as we're probably about to find out once we start pumping water here. Now this is a little scary, right? That's way more water than we could probably hold in this thing, but nonetheless, we're going to begin pumping. Hopefully we don't flood the entire base, and if we do, we may just have to deconstruct a liquid vent real quick to back everything up, but we're gonna need that water as well to flow through our lavatory and shower, which we still have not yet begun construction on. Let's see what everyone is up to. I don't really have any building tasks queued up for them right now. They're just taking care of the little stuff, you know? Harvesting plants, pushing out more mush. Looks like we made a little error in judgment when creating all this permeable tile. I've destroyed our connections to the electric grid. So nothing on this side has had any power, though to be fair, nothing really needs it. Except for the all-important supercomputers to continue our research. Possible that we found another bug. They're not going down here to build either, but that might be because we're out of resources. We're building this out of obsidian. Maybe that's the problem. No, that's the dig button, not the cancel button. Let's go in here to plumbing. I did not mean to make this out of obsidian. If anything, granite. We have a decent amount of that. Skipping ahead just a little bit, we're finally gonna get to work on the new lavatory and shower. I've connected the tiles so that they can access this whole sector. They were previously unable to even get to this outhouse. I'm so sorry, everyone. And now we're gonna get to see exactly how much this improves our mood. Are you guys so hungry? You have 0 kcals? Are you starving, my babies? Yeah, you are. If you wait just a second longer, we're at 97%, 99 on these. And the bristle blossom is still at 98, so we're not gonna be able to harvest that anytime soon. We might be starving. Let's see how mad everyone is about this. Yeah, stress level's a little high right now for Elvis. Grimy and dirty hands. He doesn't even say he's hungry. Let's take a look. How hungry are you? Calories 2100. They have some stored energy, I think. I mean, this is obviously not good. It's not ideal. There. Please go take this to the micro musher immediately, if you'd be so kind. I know you're not going to, because you never do. No, you're gonna put it in the ration box and eat it on the spot. This is why we're going to starve to death. At least a couple of you are going to die. I'm fairly confident, but I'm gonna try to stop your squealing. You are so very loud. It is obnoxious. The time is now, right? This was initially going to be the growing zone. As a result, let's take food, make some more planter boxes here. We've been waiting on this for a long time, and four more planter boxes is almost double what we've been working with right now, which admittedly has not been much. We've already got 6 millwood seeds. I should have done this a long time ago. I am so sorry. We've got 0 kcals. It's too late for this. But I'm still gonna try. It's not gonna stop me from trying. I wanna save you. Don't die on me. I can't lose you yet. They've done it. They found another emergency source of food. The game's not over yet. Another 1,000 G of muckroot puts us at 5,000 kcals. And we're making some lice loaves. We're racing the clock. And the shower and lavatory are done. No liquid output. The pipes are stuffed right now because I didn't quite finish these the way I wanted to because I was actually making them all out of obsidian. My bad. Okay, so it's gonna go a little bit over to the right. And now we're gonna have water in the lavatory and the shower. And then the output is gonna go up here. And where are we gonna dump it? That's the part I'm not sure about. Have we finished percolation? We have indeed. Research is done. That means we can have a water purifier to purify contaminated water and pump it back into our supply. I still don't know where I want the contaminated water to be pumped to, however. We were gonna have a couple of bedrooms, one on top of the other, so definitely not up here. Research was gonna go on the right. It's a possibility I could just extend the bathroom over to the left and have the water get pumped around over here. I mean, why not, right? Or I could do it on the opposite side, maybe I just need a bathroom on the opposite side. Ah, that's a good idea. Maybe just one shower and one lavatory per side. But in that case, I wouldn't want them so close together, so I want more than that. I am just talking aloud right now. Let's just plan ahead and pretend. So, for symmetry's sake, this is how the bathroom would ultimately look. And let's say that we wanted a door or a space, then a door, then another space. So the door would go here, space, and then we can have the water purifier maybe in this room. Let's see exactly how big said purifier is. I'm sure it's under refinement. We've also got access to the bio distiller. That's gonna be super important. We should probably start working on that pretty soon. Okay, water purifier. You're just gonna go next to the bathroom. I mean, why not make it close in proximity, right? And then have both of the outputs run across the top, like so, into the input of the water purifier, and from the input of the water purifier, somehow needs to loop back around. That is troublesome. Back into the system like so, and then the cycle will continue, right? And it can go wherever it wants to go. It can either go back into the shower and the lavatory, or into our stockpile. Okay, but this is gonna take a lot of work. While the whole colony has been distracting themselves from the rabid hunger that they feel deep in the pit of their stomach by creating water purifiers and showers and lavatories, you know, luxuries that not having food is kind of canceled by, we finished the pump up here. And it looks like it's having some trouble. And the reason it's having some trouble is because it's attempting to split the liquid up into the lavatory and the shower, which we can do if we change the plumbing up just a little bit here. We're missing one liquid pipe. Let's get a bit of granite to finish the connection. I had to do some deconstruction here because somebody was suffocating. And with that, we're almost complete. The water purifier itself requires electricity. So let's get the electrical conduit stretching down the back of, they're using the shower. Hold on just a second. I kind of want to see this actually. Hook that up to the grid, good. But we don't have anywhere for the water purifier to spit out the water now, do we? Who's using the shower right now? Hopefully, whoever is the most stressed right now. 46% Bay, 62 for Elvis. We're getting close to some mental snaps. Nobody ate today. I think the people are gonna be very hungry about that. We're up to 84% on a couple of planter boxes. It's not gonna be good enough. Desperately looking around for any source of food, and coming up short. Clean water goes in, dirty water comes out, everyone starts gnawing on their thumbs because they're so hungry. Seriously, no food yet? 98% here. So someone is not going to starve. At least you're going to have to fight over the food. It's going to be Hunger Games here in a second. There's only one liquid pipe left. Do I seriously need to build an additional ladder just for that? And then the water purifier will start pumping the water the way it is meant to be. Now, probably going to overpressurize what we've got going on here, unfortunately, unless we got some pressure valves. No telling how full our pool actually is, thanks to the bugs. But regardless, it's kind of cool having like a working system here. Ta-da! We can actually see the contaminated water on the left, clean water on the right, and it's pumping real fast as everyone utilizes the showers. Now, Bay, are you a little happier now despite your terrible, painful hunger? Take a look at your vitals. 48% and rising. No food available. I can see how that would be troublesome. And worst of all, probably, is everyone is idle, only thinking about food. Well, you'll have to wait until next time to see if anyone dies. Hope you've all enjoyed this series. We're getting to a nail-biting finale. Hopefully the colony doesn't die, because I feel like we're just getting started on all the cool stuff. Stay tuned. Let me know what you think I need to do next to save everyone. My name is Etalyx. I'll see you next time back in Oxygen Not Included.